Good morning.
Good morning.
So, thank you for having me here. I make a living understanding brands, building brands, and trying to make brands into success. So, what I'm going to talk about today is how can brands become successful by riding a societal change wave. So I'm going to demonstrate how four different brands have achieved remarkable success in India by trying to understand what's happening in society and how they rode the change happening in society. So let's sit back and I'll take you back in time to a kind of dark period in India's history. So let's go to 1975 when emergency was declared. Fakhruddin Ali Ahmad, the President of India, signed the emergency declaration given to him by the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, and Article 352 of the Constitution of India was invoked and all civil liberties were banned. Okay. Election was banned, liberties were banned. Within 2 months of emergency being declared, the government set out to do mass scale sterilization of men. Okay. And in fact, one brand decided to make fun of this by running this hoarding, which said compulsory sterilization. We've always practiced that. But jokes aside, that was a very, very dark period in Indian history. Okay. And fortunately for us, that within 21 months of this happening, the government called for election and a new government, a new party took over the power at the center. Okay. And they brought in a wave of pride, a wave of almost Swadeshi pride in our people. One of the first things this government did, interestingly, was to throw out two brands which were seen as signs of imperial hegemony. These two brands were IBM and Coca-Cola. Now, here was a country which was kind of celebrating its newfound freedom once again, but they didn't have the cola to celebrate with. So, in walks a brand which says, "Happy days are here again." And this brand turned out to be a brand of cola called Thumbs Up. Okay. Thumbs Up went on to kind of occupy a huge vacuum left by Coke, went on to become the number one soft drink brand in the country, kept growing, 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 and in a kind of curious twist of fate, in 1993, this brand was acquired by Coca-Cola Corporation of the USA. Okay. And today, it's 2017, it's 40 years since the launch of Thumbs Up. Two global colas have come into the country. But Thumbs Up continues to be the number one cola brand and often it's the number one soft drink brand in the country. And I think the reason why Thumbs Up continues to be so strong, there could be other reasons, like it is more carbonated, it is sweeter, it goes better with biryani. But one of the important reasons is that when it was launched, it hit on a societal wave of freedom, of being happy days are here again. So I believe Thumbs Up success probably has been contributed some way from what they did when they launched the brand. So from a simple product like a cola, now let's jump and get on to a bike. India has two types of bikes. Literally two lanes in the Indian motorcycle highway. Okay. On the one lane drives the guy who is highly economy minded, who wants 90 kilometers a liter from his mobike. And this mobike also had a legendary campaign which said, fill it, shut it, forget it. On the other lane is a guy who wants to drive fast. He wants an adrenaline rush. But this guy drives bikes like Yamaha or Pulsar. But the biker society was changing. In a sense, what was happening was that a new kind of biker was emerging. A biker who's somewhat slightly older. A biker who wanted not just economy, not just drive, but he wanted a different kind of a ride. And to hit on this new societal change came a brand called Royal Enfield. Now, Royal Enfield is a very, very, very old brand. Okay. And it was a brand which was from Chennai, my hometown, and the brand had almost died. It had become a bankrupt company, and interestingly, it was taken over in the year 1993 by Eicher Motors. Okay. Eicher Motors took over the company, I think around in the late 90s, early 2000, they took over the company, and they discovered that this was a gem which could help them open up a huge opportunity in the two-wheeler market category. And the brand was relaunched. It captured the imagination of the public in a very big way. And in 2016, you won't believe it, in 2016, Royal Enfield's market cap crossed that of Harley-Davidson. It crossed $7.5 billion and became more valuable than Harley-Davidson. And in August of 2017, Royal Enfield became the most valuable two-wheeler company in India. It crossed, the market cap crossed that of both Bajaj and Hero, were long-time leaders. So again, I think Royal Enfield's success can be attributed to some way to their ability to spot a societal change, a societal wave, and ride on that societal wave. So we saw two different brands, one from Simple Cola, the other a motorcycle. And let's move forward, let's move ahead in time and come to another brand which has created and rode on a huge societal wave. It's a brand called Paytm. It comes from a company called 197, set up by Vijay Shekhar Sharma. The company was focused basically on value-added mobile services, what we call mobile VAS. For many years, and around 2012 was when he launched Paytm. He saw an opportunity and he launched Paytm as a mobile wallet. Paytm stands for pay through mobile. Okay, and within a year he hit a download of about 20 million. But the first jump which he got was because he became the official currency for using Uber. Uber came into India in the year 2014. Uber rolled out in 11 different cities in the year 2014. And the only way to use Uber was through Paytm. And Paytm started to ride on the Uber, right, to grow in popularity. But did it stop there? No. Something dramatic happened in the year 2016. November 8, 2016 at 8 p.m., Government of India decided to demonetize rupee 500 and rupee 1000 rupee notes. Okay. This announcement was made by the Prime Minister Modi on national television at 8:01 p.m. Vijay Shekhar Sharma, the founder of this company, Paytm company, 197, was at an event at 8 p.m., he got a message. He was on stage, a stage like this, and he walked out in 5 minutes. People wondering where he was going, but here was a guy who knew how to ride a wave. Okay, so he went back to his office, and obviously he must have talked to a lot of people and got various permissions. But within 8 hours of the government making that announcement about demonetization, he had got this ad out in every newspaper in the country, congratulating Prime Minister Modi, congratulating the government of India for putting India on a route for digital currency. So 8 hours later, or probably 6 hours later, the ad was out. And within a few days, he had Paytm signs put up everywhere. His people were out on the roads. you know, converting merchants to start using Paytm. So Paytm suddenly rode up, okay, on this societal wave and literally became the second largest used currency in the country. Till then, he had a lot of competition from others. But by riding on that, and I think he took the wind out of the sail of everyone else. The credit card companies did not move fast enough. Debit companies did not move fast enough. The other payment wallets did not move fast enough. But Paytm, Vijay Shekhar Sharma, moved extremely fast and to get onto that wave and literally became the second currency of India, if there can be a second currency. Okay, so we saw a cola, we saw a motorcycle, we saw a digital product. Okay. Now let's now look at a brand which has been in the news almost continuously for the last 3 to 4 years. This brand started actually as a humble yoga guru. This country, India, has probably 100,000 or probably 200,000 yoga gurus. Baba Ramdev also started as a yoga guru. And apparently when he started in the year 1993 at Haridwar, he had two students attending his classes. Okay, two students. But soon his fame spread. He could do all kinds of contortions and he became very popular. He started having big yoga, mass demonstrations of yoga. In Haridwar, people used to travel from all over the northern part of India to go and do this, learn this yoga from this yogic guru. And I think in the year 2005-6, he tied up with a television channel called Sanskar and started, you know, airing his yoga programs. And then later he took ownership of a television channel called Asta TV to again get his yoga message out to the public. But his success is not just because he was a very good yoga teacher. His success was he could understand something happening in society. And he, in 2011, decided to protest against corruption in high places in the government. Okay, he went on a hunger strike. He got huge mass following. And suddenly, someone who was probably 10 years ago just a yoga teacher in Haridwar became the face of middle-class India. Face of India which was ready to stand up and protest against injustice, protest against corruption. And in a parallel move, Baba Ramdev also had launched, in fact, apparently the story is he used to sell Chyawanprash from his cycle in the year 1993, 94, 95. So he had been selling these products, but suddenly these products started growing and he started expanding the range of products. And his company's turnover, which is Patanjali Products turnover, went from something like $70 million in the year 2011. It doubled every year, went from 75 to 150 to 300 to 600 to $1 billion. The year 2016, he hit $1.6 billion. And I think he'll probably cross $2 billion in terms of total sales of all products put together in the year 2017. Now, people have been saying he's successful because he makes natural products, because his product is Ayurvedic, you know, because his products are cheap, because he's got mass distribution. I think all of that is true. Okay. Yes, his products are probably 30 to 40% cheaper than the products made by market leaders. Yes, correct. Okay. His products are made by and large with a lot of natural ingredients. True, correct. But I think more important than all that, I think his success is also because he has been able to become the symbol of a middle-class India who's wanting to feel proud of its origins, who's willing to stand up and fight for its rights. And so he's not just a great yoga master. He's not just a great yoga guru, but he's a lot more. And he's been able to ride this societal wave in order to build a $2 billion business. No company in India has been able to go from something like 100 million to 2 billion in the consumer product space. No company has been able to do this in less than the way what he's achieved. He's done that is what, 7 years, 8 years? Amazing story. And I don't think the story is over. Apparently, he's going to get into apparel now, right? And he's going to continue this. And he's not just going to be selling yoga pants. He's going to be selling probably jeans and all kinds of things, right? Because I think somewhere he's been able to hit on this thing that you can trust Baba Ramdev to give you what is of great value. So just to conclude is that what we saw is all these so-called great brands, which is thumbs up to Royal Enfield, to Paytm, to Patanjali, were all good brands, right? To be good in marketing, you have to offer great value. They offer great value. Okay, you have to connect with consumers. So in classic marketing, we brand building, we talk of rational reasons and emotional reasons. These brands all fulfill a very good rational reason, a very full emotional reason. But more than all this, I think these brands demonstrate how you can achieve brand success if you can understand what is happening in society and you can ride that societal change. You can call it avalanche, you can call it landslide, but all these brands demonstrate that if you go beyond simple rational emotional reasons, understand a larger societal context of your brand, you can achieve great success. So thank you very much for patient listening.